The only one left was the little girl, Hind. She said, please, I'm little, I'm injured, I peed myself.
Hind stayed on the phone with the Red Crescent for hours.
What time is it? She said it's getting dark. I'm afraid of the dark.
The area was too dangerous, hard to reach. They had to keep Hind on the phone as they scrambled to try and get a team to her.
6-year-old Hind Rajab, a Palestinian girl who was trapped in a car with her dead relatives following IDF shelling, has been found dead. Now, the two paramedics who attempted to save her were also killed as they were attempting to save her. Hind was fleeing Gaza in a car with her aunt, uncle, and three cousins when they were attacked by Israeli gunfire. According to BBC News, audio recordings of calls between Hind and emergency call operators suggest that the 6-year-old was the only one left alive in the car, hiding from Israeli forces among the bodies of her relatives. Her pleas for someone to come and rescue her ended when the phone line was cut and you could hear gunfire in the background. So this next video is difficult to watch. I wanted to give you that warning. Let's take a look.
A desperate call for help from 6-year-old Hind, terrified, trapped in a car. Everyone around her is dead. Hind was in the car with her uncle, his wife, and their four children, trying to flee fighting from this part of northern Gaza. The horror in that car captured in this call for help from her cousin, recorded by the Palestine Red Crescent. Her mother's desperation was pretty brutal to watch as well, but this is the reality that Palestinians have been dealing with for several months now at the hands of the Israeli government and the IDF that will not spare a single civilian life. Here's a perfect example of that.
No one more desperate for answers than Hind's distraught mother.
If my daughter didn't die from the bullets, she is going to die from the cold, from the hunger. My daughter said, Mama, I am hungry. She said, Mama, I am thirsty, I'm cold. I call on the whole world to bring me back my daughter. I want anyone to call the army. We want our innocent little girl. Hind is too young to be going through this. She is too young.
So paramedics were finally able to reach the vehicle, and once they did, they saw that it was covered in bullets. And think about it, I mean, this 6-year-old girl is trapped in a car with dead relatives, and she died that way. Paramedics from the Palestinian Red Crescent Society managed on Saturday to reach the area, which had previously been closed off as an active combat zone. They found the black Kia car Hind had been traveling in, its windscreen and dashboard smashed to pieces, bullet holes scattered across the side. One paramedic told journalists that Hind was among the 6 bodies found inside the car, all of which showed signs of gunfire and shelling. A few meters away were the remains of another vehicle completely burnt out, its engine spilling onto the ground. This, the Red Crescent says, is the ambulance sent to fetch Hind. Cenk.
Okay, so let me be clear. The Israeli Defense Forces are terrorists. And so again, if that offends you, that probably means you're a right-wing Israeli or a right-wing American and you've lost your mind and you're totally detached from reality. By the way, I'm curious, did they see her before they murdered her? Or were they just murdering everyone in the car? And they're like, oh, a 6-year-old was in the car too, so what? She's Palestinian, she doesn't care, she doesn't mind.
Cenk, I'm sorry to jump in, but like, no, this isn't simply a right-wing ideology, okay? There are plenty of Democrats who are totally in favor of what the IDF is doing. They will provide cover for the IDF. It doesn't matter what kind of war crimes they engage in, they will support it. Now, the majority of support does in fact come from conservatives, but there are plenty of Democrats who are supportive of this as well.
Well, as usual, I'll give a caveat to that, which is, the polling indicates that there are very few Democrats who are in favor of this kind of terrorism from Israel.
Voters, correct.
That's right.
Yeah.
But the politicians,
yes,
are completely bought by defense contractors in AIPAC. If you are offended that they're bought, or well, then I'm offended that they're bought. But if you're offended that I'm saying they're bought, you're again detached from reality. No one agrees with you. Everyone sees the millions of dollars in campaign contributions going from AIPAC, Democratic Majority for Israel, Raytheon, Lockheed Martin, Boeing, etc. We're not blind. So the rest of the media can lie all they want. Democratic politicians and Republican politicians are tripping over themselves as to who can help the terrorists more. And so right now they're like, they're Democrats, they're like, oh, please, let's give $14 billion to the terrorists. And the Republicans are like, no, let's give $17 billion to the terrorists. You tell me if that isn't terrorism. If you think killing, murdering that 6-year-old little girl wasn't terrorism, that what? They saw already, I mean, they did it up close. They didn't get her the first time around. She was in there for a long, long time. They see the dead people in the car, then they fire in. Even though it's an obvious family, they don't care about the families. If you've been brainwashed by American media telling you, oh, Israel's trying really hard to avoid civilian casualties, they're just the most incompetent military, and they miss almost every time they drop a bomb. Oops, oh, they didn't know they were in the tunnels, and the tunnels are unaffected by the bombing. They just were dropping all those bombs by accident. Oh, look, they blew up a university. They blew up a mosque on purpose with the controlled devices, etc. Oh, maybe Hamas was there at some point. God, the idiot Americans tell the world and their voters that, oh, we did it by accident. You put improvised devices in to blow up the buildings that were empty. Why? Because you don't want any education in Gaza. You're trying to destroy Gaza. And you've done a great job at it. So don't tell me you're not terrorists. The Israeli Defense Forces are definite, definite terrorists. Okay, so they murdered that 6-year-old girl. If that doesn't break your heart, you're a monster. If you think that they did it by accident, you're a moron. I'm not having that conversation. Total, utter moron if you think they did that by accident. Was the other 11,500 children also by accident? 36 dead Israeli kids, and we all said, oh my God, that's the worst thing we've ever seen. 36, breaks your heart. We showed all the kids, everybody showed it all over TV, right? Now 11,500 dead children, but they're Palestinians. So just admit it, you think that their lives don't matter. If you're an American politician or an Israeli politician, you think, who cares about that little girl? Murder her! That's what Biden says. Why do you think they call him Genocide Joe? He goes and tells voters, oh no, no, I chastised Israel a tiny, tiny bit. So I'm so moral. No, Joe Biden is a sick, disgusting, immoral person who didn't mind that little girl died. And you think Trump's any better? No, Trump's like, oh, kill them more, kill all their family members and ban them. So these are the monsters that run the American government. So finally, how about the ambulance? Go ahead, Israeli supporters. What's your BS excuse for the ambulance? It's an ambulance. It's not like it's unclear. Oh, was it a taxi or was it an ambulance? It's super duper clear. They murdered everyone inside the ambulance because they were going to rescue that little girl.
They have bombed ambulances. They have, not banned, bombed. They have bombed ambulances. They have bombed humanitarian aid convoys, which we've shown you evidence of. Just a few weeks ago, we showed you video that was shot by a UK outlet on the ground in Gaza. A group of Palestinians, one Palestinian man waving a white flag, attempted to get back into a building to escort two of his family members out of the building before Israel started bombing said building. And you know what they did as he was waving a white flag and being super careful to make sure that the IDF knows that he's not a threat to them? They shot him. As reporters were right there with their cameras up and ready to go. It was on camera.
IDF is not killing these people. Let's be clear about our terminology. The IDF is murdering these people. When you see someone with a white flag and you kill them, that is a murder. And by the way, they murdered three of their own hostages. They rescued two the other day, they had rescued one in the beginning. So they're now at zero because they rescued three and murdered three. So if you still think the Israeli Defense Forces are a force for good and that they're in any way moral, you're just lying to yourself. And good news, no one else believes you. The whole world sees the monsters that Israeli Defense Forces are. Now when you see someone in an IDF uniform, I know they have conscription and I feel bad for the people who don't want to participate in that. And there are other forces inside Israel. And those forces need to get larger and stronger immediately to retake their country. Because right now the people representing you are wall-to-wall terrorists.
I have to add what happened to those two paramedics who tried to save that little girl, because apparently in a statement, the Palestinian Red Crescent accused Israel of deliberately targeting the ambulance as soon as it arrived on the scene. This was on January 29th. They say that the Israeli occupation deliberately targeted the Red Crescent crew despite obtaining prior coordination to allow the ambulance to arrive at the scene to rescue the child Hind. The Palestinian Red Crescent also told BBC that it had taken several hours to coordinate access with the Israeli army in order to send the paramedics to her to try to rescue her. We got the coordination, we got the green light. On arrival, the crew confirmed that they could see the car where Hind was trapped and they could see her. The last thing we heard is continuous gunfire.
Terrorists, obvious, over the top, terrorists. So don't tell me Hamas killed 36 children and they're the world's worst terrorists, and then you kill over 11,000 and you do it when you know there's a child in the car and you go to murder the child and you murder the people trying to rescue her in the ambulance. Don't tell me you're not terrorists. At this point, you are 25 times the size of the terrorists that Hamas are. That is what Israel is as we stand. They are a democracy, and they at least within Israel, and not with the, of course, the 5 million people that they imprison and oppress and occupy and belittle and humiliate and murder. But inside Israel, they are a democracy. So show it. If you're decent Israel, you have to show it right now, because right now the face you're putting forward to the rest of the world is of great indecency, immorality and terrorism. So that's the whole look, whether I say it or not, the entire world now when they see the Israeli flag, they go, "Oh boy, watch out for those terrorists."
It's not a lie. Don't be fooled by the cover that the United States media provides for Israel. Even Israel's allies on the international stage are really starting to question their support. And even Japan has ceased some of their trade with Israel as a result of their conduct in the Gaza Strip.
Thanks for watching the video, guys. We also love it if you hit the join button below, because that makes you a member. And members allow us to be independent, honest. We could be as progressive as we want, no corporate media influence. And that's all because of you guys. We love doing the show with our members. Hit the join button, become one of the Young Turks.